Welcome back. In this episode, we look at the operation of semaphore signals in iTrain 5.1, where the new red on exit feature may not be appropriate for a semaphore signal. As we have already seen, the prototypical behaviour of a light signal in the scenario shown is for the signal to change to red immediately on exiting the block and not to wait until the train has entered the next block before changing to red. So that is now the behaviour you will see in 5.1 for all regional light signals except for the Swiss signals. As we've stated before, Swiss signals will not change to red until the entire train has entered the next block. It is simply the way that Swiss signals operate in the real world. Effectively, Swiss signals retain the same behaviour that was in iTrain 5.0. And for mechanical semaphore signals, in most regions, it is also often the case that a semaphore signal will not change to red or the stop aspect immediately the train exits the block. More typically, it will only change to the stop aspect later, such as when it enters the next block. So how can we replicate that operation in iTrain 5.1 if we are using a physical semaphore signal? Because with the new signal behaviour in 5.1, the semaphore signal will immediately change to red or the stop aspect. Well, if you use German signals, it is easy to do it in iTrain because the German regional signals include dedicated semaphore signals and they automatically operate with the same behaviour as in iTrain 5.0. For all other regions, there are currently no dedicated semaphore signals to choose from in iTrain. So what can we do for other regional systems? Well, if your system operates from the right-hand side, like German signals, you can simply select one of the German semaphore signals. The icon may not be the same as your regional semaphore signal, but its operation will be similar. If your signalling system operates on the left-hand side of the track, such as in the UK, we can also use the German semaphore signals, but just be aware that these need to be orientated to use the right side of the track when placed on the iTrain switchboard. The fact that the physical signal on your real layout is on the left-hand side doesn't matter to iTrain. Using the German semaphore signal produces the behaviour we want, waiting until later before the signal turns to red. The alternative for left-handed signals is to use the Swiss light signals. Why the Swiss signals? Well, because Swiss signals use the left side of the track, and Swiss signals wait until the entire train has entered the next block before changing to red. Remember, in iTrain, when we select a signal type, we are selecting the logical or software representation of the signal. That includes details of how the signal behaves and how the symbol is displayed on the switchboard. The fact that the physical device is a light or a semaphore doesn't matter to iTrain. iTrain will cause the physical signal to operate as per the characteristics of the logical signal element. iTrain doesn't care if the symbol on the switchboard doesn't look like the real physical item. And for the time being, until and if more signal types are available in iTrain, nor should we. So there you are. That is how to replicate the behaviour of a semaphore signal on your layout, should you wish to do so. That is all for this tutorial. In the next tutorial, we look at a more advanced example of using signals and turnout feedbacks by looking at the approach to the throat of a station. So until then, bye for now.